The topic this morning is youth literacy, and we are fortunate again to have my granddaughter, Alana McLaughlin, who has given us a youth perspective in terms of reading, recognizing that the state of Tennessee is the last in terms of literacy among the 50 states. And the reason we mention this, Alana, is primarily because we want you to address this issue of literacy in the state of Tennessee in terms of what we are trying to do in terms of making sure that more young people your age, and as we said earlier, 8 years old, more young people will be more familiar with what they have to do about reading.
Mm-hmm. Well, I really want to encourage kids 8 and under to really read, because some parents who can't read, their children want to be exactly like them. But I personally encourage all kids to read, because reading is a good thing, because it lets your imagination run free. It gives you information that you may have not known, such as, what if you wanted to learn the names of some states? Maybe you can read a book about the states of all 50, and maybe you can find the names of those states. Books give you information, and they let your imagination run wild, such as The Cat in the Hat. Mm-hmm. Personally, I love Green Eggs and Ham. Mm-hmm. I mean, not the food, but the book. Mm-hmm. I'm not a Green Eggs and Ham eater.
Go on, Alana. Go on.
Well, this is one of the books that I'm reading right now. It's called Mystery Isle by Judith St. George. It's mainly about 12-year-old Kimball, who isn't looking forward to leaving New York City for a summer on Shag Island in Maine. The island and the mansion that sits on it have been in Kimball's family for generations, but now Kim's great-grandfather intends to sell both the island and the house. Kim and her mother busy themselves with preparations, but when Mom is called away on business, Kim and great-grandpa find themselves alone on the island. Strange music, bright flashing lights, and an exotic parrot convince great-grandpa that he's losing his right mind, like his father before him. But Kim knows what she saw, and as she digs into the mystery, soon she realizes they are in grave danger. Mm-hmm. It's up to Kimball Lauder to discover what or who is haunting Shag Island.
Very good. And so Lana, I think you've demonstrated to the audience this morning that there's some truth in the fact that while you might be in the third grade, that you are in reality reading on perhaps the fifth grade level.
Yes.
And I also understand that you've done a number of things in your school to encourage young people that you work with to read and to be more studious. Why don't you tell us something about some of your tutoring activities? And I know it's strange to talk about you being a tutor, but go on, talk about it.
Well, I'm in a tutoring class at my school at Glen Enhanced Option Elementary, and I help one student named Anaya. She is the daughter of Mrs. Natasha Massey, and sometimes I help her with her homework or help her complete a page of work. And basically, I'm one out of three other helpers.
And so you're not the main helper, but you are. They have enough confidence in you in the third grade to allow you to do something. And I also understand that at one time you were even contemplating, even at your age, of starting a tutoring school.
Because me and my family moved to Madison a couple of days back, and I was trying to save enough money to buy our house. As we live in Madison, I was thinking of using the house to tutor, but eventually somebody bought the house before me. Very sad.
And so your whole situation in terms of being a tutor, starting a tutoring school,
yes,
sort of went to the side and something. But
yes.
Now you've been involved in reading and learning for a long time.
Book fairs. You know, sometimes I go to every book fair. If there is a free book that I like on sale, everybody knows I'm going to buy it. Because every person in my third grade class of Miss Wendy Anderson calls me, quote, a book bookworm because I have stacks of books at my table. Mm-hmm. I have a million gazillion books, even if it's from the movie Tangled or, hey, Mystery Isle. Mm-hmm. There is a book laying on my desk. If you don't see one, your eyes are deceiving you.
Mm-hmm. And so you, in other words, you want to encourage all young people your age or below that it's so important to you that they read, that you're even coming on national television and trying to make that as a point. Is that what mm-hmm. you're trying to do today?
Yes, I'm trying to raise awareness for reading. All I have to say is read, read, read. Read until you can't see, read until you pass away, read until you can't hear, read until you sleep, read for 24 hours straight, and I would be the proudest woman, girl on earth. I just want to raise awareness for children to read, 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 become a bookworm, read, read, read.
Lana, I think before we made a decision that this would have something to do with youth literacy, mm-hmm. I think one of your earlier ideas, and I think this is something that we can probably pursue mm-hmm. during the last segment, your earlier idea was to talk about children and drugs.
Yes.
And I was so taken back by that because I recognized that you being in the third grade, and only 8 years old, I was sort of, I wondered exactly what could you tell us at this age about children and drugs, and so, but you contend that you've read a lot of information mm-hmm. in reference to, let's talk about that. We've got 50 seconds before the end of this segment, and then, so let's wait a few seconds, but when we come back after this commercial break, I want you to think about why you would tell me mm-hmm. that you thought that the whole issue of children and drugs, and especially young children, because we never think in terms of 6 or 7 year old children being concerned with drugs one way or the other.
All I have to say is just stay tuned because you're in for a treat. That's all I can tell you. Stay tuned.
Well, and I think that over the last 14 seconds that we have here,
you don't know what's coming up. Neither do I, so I'm a
thief. Stay tuned because Lana's going to talk about children and substance abuse. The topic